Chancellor of Exchequer George Osborne and the Schools Minister David Laws will be hosting the Fonz at a Downing Street reception tonight.
The actor Henry Winkler is in the UK touring schools to raise awareness of the needs of the 1 in 5 children with learning difficulties.
We spoke to him a little while ago, along with Nikki Cox, who's the editor of the children's newspaper First News, which is running the campaign. He told us first what it was like coping with dyslexia as a child.
You know, you think you're stupid. Everybody says, well, you're lazy, you're never going to achieve. Well, it's really sad. And he's in the bottom 10% in the class. And I thought to myself, I don't want to be stupid. I don't think I'm stupid. But I must be because everybody is telling me. And then as you develop, you realize, you know, last Thursday, I realized for the first time, hey, maybe I'm not stupid. Do you know? I just have a learning challenge. And 1 out of 5 children have some sort of learning challenge. And each time I come here, I like to talk to them and say, you've got greatness inside you.
So how do the two of you help them in practical terms, people who have reading problems?
Well, I mean, basically, Henry is there as an example of somebody who went through school really struggling, as he's just explained, felt really stupid, didn't find out, in fact, that he was dyslexic until he was 31, so spent his whole childhood feeling that he wasn't keeping up with everybody else. And we identify those kids in schools. I mean, we first toured together for the National Year of Reading. It wasn't actually anything to do with this issue, but it became so apparent when Henry started talking that it was a huge issue. These children would come up to him and sort of say, you know, I'm dyslexic too, you know, as if it was something to be ashamed of. And we sort of said there and then, hey, we've got to do something about this because these children are falling through the cracks. And not only are they having a hard time at school, but because they grow up feeling bad about themselves, they end up in this downward spiral. You know, they get bullied, so they start truanting, they get involved in gangs, and there's a massive over-representation of dyslexics and other people with learning challenges in prison. In America, in some states, they do reading tests in the fourth grade when they're 8 years old to determine how many prison cells they need to build in 10 years' time. So, you know, we need to make these kids realize that they
are
special.
There is a glass half full to this, you know. As opposed to thinking about how many prison cells you need to, how about how many children you can allow to meet their potential?
And you can have someone who's got dyslexia being an author.
Well, that was a shock.
How many books have you done now?
That was a shock. 23. There are 23 novels. There are Hank Zipsers. There are 17 Hank Zipsers through Walker Books. I think that he might be a television series because he's very funny.
And he's the world's greatest underachiever.
Underachiever, yes. Hank Zipser, his glass is half full. He just spills it everywhere.
Now, how do you do this? You've got a co-author.
I have a co-author. She sits at the computer. I walk around her office. I talk, she types. She has an idea, she types, I wait. She reads it back to me, and then we argue over every word.
Now, my generation, I was going to say, we all loved, and I was greatly enamoured of the Fonz. I have to declare that interest.
You're using the past tense.
Well, does the Fonz still exist?
Oh, yes.
He does.
Yes.
He'll be there forever on reruns.
I hope so.
But do the children, because they wouldn't have seen the Fonz.
It doesn't matter. See, that's the great thing. I don't care if a child knows that I exist on the earth. When I'm in that classroom, I get letters back and they say, how did you know me so well?
The other thing about you is you've made contributions to the English language, not just your books, but we've got phrases coming out of Happy Days. I mean, we've got Jumping the Shark.
Jumping the Shark was invented by a man named John Heim when he was at Michigan University. He was sitting with his friend, and they came up with that when they thought a television show had
gone too far, when it had a character jumping.
Of course, Happy Days was number one for 5 years after that. But
do you use it yourself? Do you say that?
I have never used it.
You've never used it?
Never used it. Don't mind it. Yeah. Met the man, actually, for the first time in 33 years. Finally met him on his radio.
Because I was reading in one of your other acting roles, you did it again. You jumped another show.
I am the only actor in the world who has jumped the shark twice, the second time on Arrested Development. That is true.
Nikki, you're in Downing Street tonight launching this latest campaign.
Yep.
Obviously, there's a new generation of children constantly coming on who need to be encouraged, but overall, are we getting better at dealing with dyslexic children, not helping them?
I think that we are, because we're working at the reception tonight that First News is holding at number 11. We've got Achievement for All coming as well, and they're a charity that we're working with and have done for the last 2 years now, who are actually working in schools in the country, doing what it says on the tin, Achievement for All. And they are having a massive effect, not only on the kids that have learning challenges, but on everybody else. They have this kind of system where they work with the school, the kids, and the parents, and bring them all together.
And they're very successful. Results, yeah. Achievement for All is very successful in changing the nature of how the child is treated in the school. Then you've also got a lot of teachers right here in the United Kingdom that are trained specifically for children who learn differently. For a while there, I was associated with the Teachers Award here in England, and I've met some extraordinary teachers who know about the child with their challenges.
Yeah, I mean, the only nervousness now is obviously the curriculum is under review, so we're watching very closely. David Laws is going to be at Downing Street with us tonight to make sure that curriculum remembers the children that maybe learn in a different way.
Okay, thank you both very much indeed.
What a pleasure. You.